The Enterprise arrives at the planet that the Orion had given them the coordinates to. Why is Archer moving around the ship like a chimpanzee? An unknown ship attacks them from inside the atmosphere, but its weapons are so weak that even weakling Enterprise can shrug off their attacks and it's no threat to them at all. So, naturally, Archer wants to blow it out of the sky.
It's the Starfleet way.
Reed refuses to use his weapons to murder them. Let me repeat that. Malcolm Reed, while under the testosterone spell himself, doesn't want to use his powerful weapons to blow up another ship. What is wrong with Archer in this episode if Reed is still able to hold back on this? Kelvin gets visited by his own Green Babe and cut to commercial!
Smarter, younger.
You're better than him.
Okay, this is actually kind of interesting because the episode after this is the two-parter in the Mirror Universe, and Archer, well, Mirror Universe Archer, is going to have a very similar shot. Does that make this a clever callback to this episode? I don't know. Season 4, you can actually get away with calling Enterprise clever, though, so I'm going to give him credit. And the Orion woman weenie shames Kelvin into mutiny.
I'm used to being with men who take what they want.
Tough break, Toots. I need a man who answers to no one. A full manager.
Machi, machi.
He goes to engineering and sabotages the ship, and Trip knocks him out, but not before he did his damage.
What's wrong with him?
It's the same thing that's affecting everyone on this ship. It's a highly potent pheromone.
Dude, Phlox sounds like Beldar Conehead here.
I suspect the pheromone acts as a defense mechanism against competition.
Grid-like breakfast slabs, extruded mammal tailings, seared strips of swine flesh, and flattened chicken embryos. I will enjoy it.
Of course, if you had examined them as soon as they came on board, like logical common sense says you should have, you might have picked it up then. Also, Star Trek really seems to like the women kicking out different stinks, doesn't it?
My body is producing an unusually elevated level of what you would call pheromones. The effect can be quite provocative. Perhaps you sense it.
You can always uncork the pheromones.
I beg your pardon.
It causes them to project their emotions onto others.
You see, our bodies produce a sort of pheromone, which blocks the long-term memory engrams of others.
If we could duplicate Deanna's pheromones and then convince him that she's no longer in sickbay, that she'd gone into some other part of the ship.
Happens a lot. And Trip and T'Pol are the only ones who are immune.
Why me?
I would have to run some more tests. For the rest of us, the effect seems to be cumulative.
Flindar.
Archer locks up the women and discovers that they've been in contact with the Orion captain this whole time.
Damn it! It's time to start telling me the truth!
You're reverting me back to season one. It's awful! But he's so twisted up, he still nearly lets them go because their stink is so strong.
Well, I have been wearing the same outfits for several days, so... And now you temporarily cede command to T'Pol because...
You're not immune to these pheromones. Your judgment is impaired.
I can handle it.
Because of course not. Logic has no power here.
Season one!
You really think they're coming after us?
It's likely.
You know, I keep thinking back to our first mission when we met the Sulaban.
Well, time is of the essence. You and I, the only two people who are unaffected by all this, so let's chat about the past. And the men keep acting like brutish thugs because apparently the brig cannot be cut off from all the air supply, so their stink cannot be purged from the ship right now. T'Pol figures out that the psychic bond from all their previous season 3 canoodling must be what's making them immune to pheromones. What?
So immune to pheromones that a couple years ago a disease turned me into Miley Cyrus.
And the Orion pirate returns and again to ask for their surrender. Turns out this whole thing was orchestrated to cripple them, both to make their crew unresponsive and to actually cripple the ship, so that they can take Archer and turn him into the Orion Syndicate.
The Syndicate wants your head, Captain. And they don't really care whether or not it's attached to your body.
And without the maneuverability of their engines, the fight goes very badly as the Orion just keeps blasting their weapons apart. He cripples, then grapples the Enterprise.
I'm afraid you have an appointment with a pair of Orion marauders.
Release my ship!
I can see you're upset. And I sympathize. But it's truly out of my hands. We are both slaves to the situation.
They control you?
You finally realize that.
Oh, there's the stupid retcon I was referring to.
Yes, Captain, you've been operating under a misconception. It It is the men who are the slaves, not the women.
The Orions have not come up often in Star Trek, but when they have, it's always been the same idea, that they're a bunch of brutes and pirates who run their empire in a very thuggish manner, and the women are just sold off as slaves, hypersexual, really seductive slaves. So now, at nearly the end of the Prime Universe run of the show, we're going to suddenly rearrange the entire society. Granted, again, the Orions are not often brought up, so they're not a foundational concept of Star Trek, but they have been there since before Kirk, so this is an old group. This would be like saying that the Ferengi are actually run by their women, who secretly pretend to be dominated while they're running things. And while that certainly is an interesting idea, and not even necessarily a bad way to go, it's just too late to suddenly reverse everything like this. Show this relatively early, redefine the society, then we might be able to do something. But at this point, his ship has sailed on who the Orions are, people.
This would be like a flashback in Return of the Jedi where Darth chops off Han Solo's hand. You can't do this.
Trip and T'Pol figure out a trick that can actually disable the ship, but the women have actually escaped because they asked to escape.
You'd be playing a prisoner who asks if he can leave, and the warden says yes.
And then I leave?
Yeah, that's it. Not a very interesting story.
Yeah. Archer and Reed are literally brainwashed by the sexy. Trip comes to the bridge and stuns both Archer and Reed.
And you don't stun the women because...
they're too empowered to be a threat.
Oh yeah, they're real empowered. That's why we keep showing them butt first!
So Trip and T'Pol use their trick and zap the rope, and of course, with just one little energy beam, they're able to disable the entire Orion ship. Eh, it's the end of the show, why not? They turn their boobs toward Trip, but T'Pol owns those testicles, thank you very much. So Trip refuses their sexiness, and they just submit and walk away. That's it. They did this whole plan, but as soon as their one technique failed, they'll just give up.
Yeah, that's it. Not a very interesting story.
And you're claiming that you're the people who run an entire empire secretly?
Great dancers, terrible pirates.
You are without doubt the worst pirate I've ever heard of.
And no, we really haven't heard of you either.
Approximately 70 years ago, Orion women held dominion over the men. But in a revolt and after a civil war, the men gained control.
And of course, Dr. Phlox's magical injections will hit the reset button and everyone will be as they were.
We already had enough continuity earlier in the episode. Come on, we ran out.
You'll be glad to know my log won't mention your firing on a fellow officer.
Will it mention your bloodlust and wanting to shoot a person out of the sky because he offended you?
At least we've learned something about the Orions.
Yeah, the women are in charge.
And yet, no one will ever mention it again, and centuries from now, we'll still act like the men are actually in charge.
It proves that even the most disagreeable species have some positive attributes.
Was that my imagination? It almost sounded like you were making a joke.
At least trying to make one.
Yeah, she has the writers from Enterprise. Don't expect too much. And it turns out that we actually are going to have a brief change in continuity. Kind of, since they never really got rid of Trip, truly. Because he's asked for a transfer back to Enterprise. So, let me see if I get this straight. You give him a promotion, and he goes to another ship. But he doesn't actually go to that ship. He hangs around the Enterprise anyway. And then he gets a transfer back to the ship, so he never really left the ship. And we're going to call that a story arc.
Yeah, that's it. Not a very interesting story.
Also, it means you were lying to Kelvin at the beginning when you said this.
As soon as the repairs are done, I'm back on Columbia.
Liar! Liar! Liar!
Also, is this the theme of the episode? Ladies, true power only comes from your sexuality? If so, thanks but no thanks. And screw you, Gene Roddenberry.
Yeah, especially when you consider that it was only sexuality that saved them, too. Other sexuality. Hump the right people, ladies! And so we end this episode with a tease for a ship that's already come and gone. No pun intended. And that's Bound. It is not the worst Enterprise by a long shot, but in my opinion, this is easily the worst of Season 4. Season 4 Enterprise was a big shoot up in quality, and this really felt like a Season 1 episode. If this had happened in Season 1, it would have fit right in. The story is predictable. You can tell these women are going to be a danger from the very beginning. anyone who knows Star Trek knows that there's like a seductive magic about them, whether it's pheromonal or just something spiritual or psychic or whatever. They've known that the women have this literally for the first episode of Star Trek, again, before there was even a Kirk. And so this is only going to be a surprise to the people who don't care about Star Trek and are only watching this for the first time. And by the way, God help you if Enterprise is your first taste of Star Trek.
Those poor people.
And of course, it's completely demeaning to women under the guise of empowerment. Yes, the women run everything, but they run everything badly.
And through their vaginas.
Exclusively so. So as usual, decide for yourselves. But as for me, I'm calling this one POS ENT.